should talk about those things. But I wanted to examine for a few minutes the other kind of suffering that Jesus went through, and it's something that you and I can relate to, because you know, we've never had a crown of thorns stuck in our heads, and we've never been nailed to a cross. But there's something that Jesus went through at that time, and it's something that we've gone through too, although Jesus went through it much worse. And that is a broken heart. That's the broken heart of rejection. Now, you know, I know you guys look at me and I'm like an old man and everything, and it's hard to believe this, but I actually was a kid at one time, a long, long time ago. And so I kind of relate to you guys in that I know that sometimes you guys feel rejected, because I did too sometimes when I was a kid. And I was thinking about, you know, when I was in the fifth grade, there was a time when my family moved and I went to a new school. And, you know, I was never a popular kid or anything. I was really skinny, I was awkward, I was shy. And so I went to this new school, and I was surprised that the two most popular boys in the school welcomed me into their little clique, into their popular club, you know. And I'm like, wow, this is cool, I've never experienced this before. And, you know, these two popular boys are friends with me. And it was great while it lasted. But about a week later, for some reason, you know, just like that, they decided, not only was I not in the popular group, but for some reason they hated me. And, you know, the name calling and some, you know, bullying and stuff like that. And I'm like, you know, I don't know why I was popular for a week, and I don't know why they switched, but I felt rejected. And maybe you guys have been through something like that. There was another time a couple years later when my mom and dad came to me, and they told me that they were getting a divorce. And I know I shouldn't, now I know I shouldn't have felt this, but at the time, I kind of wondered if it was my fault. And I wondered, is my dad leaving because maybe he doesn't like me anymore, or, you know. Now I know, looking back, that I was wrong. It was just that my mom and dad couldn't get along. And if you guys, if any of your parents are having marriage problems, it's not your fault. Don't ever think that. I know kids think that sometimes, but it's not true. But I felt rejected. So, you know, maybe you guys can think about the times when you felt rejected. Well, Jesus knows exactly how you feel. Because there was a time, you know, well, before I say that, I just want to mention, you know, of course, Jesus spent his life helping people, right? He would minister to the crowds. He would heal the sick. He fed the 5,000. He fed the 3,000. You know, worked miracles for them, taught them about God, always showed love, and, you know, Jesus was always meeting people's needs. There was one time when Jesus had a need, and I want to think about the people who could have helped him in his time of need. See, the religious leaders, Pharisees, the scribes, they were the ones who knew the law of Moses. They were the ones who read the Bible all the time and memorized verses, and they impressed people with how much they knew about the Bible. And you would think that they would be the ones to help Jesus in this time of need. Unfortunately, they rejected him because they were jealous of Jesus. See, Jesus was getting bigger crowds than they were getting, and Jesus was teaching things that they didn't like. And so they were the ones who actually started to cause Jesus' problem, his time of trouble. And so they ended up arresting Jesus. Well, the religious leaders brought Jesus to the Roman government. Now you would think the Roman government would help Jesus in this time of trouble. They, at that time, you know, Israel, or as it was called at the time, Palestine, was ruled by the Romans. And, you know, they're supposed to uphold the law, and they're supposed to make sure that an innocent man doesn't get punished. Well, even though Pontius Pilate, who was the ruler of that area, even though he admitted that Jesus had done nothing wrong, he said, I find no guilt in this man. But he still rejected Jesus, and he said, okay, you can crucify him. Well, what about the crowds? I mentioned earlier that Jesus had spend his time doing good and healing the sick and teaching them and even feeding them and working miracles for the people. Did the crowds help Jesus in this time of need? I mean, the religious leaders arrested Jesus. The Romans decided to crucify him. Unfortunately, the crowds rejected Jesus too. The crowds who at one time were happy when Jesus worked miracles for them and, you know, ate the food that he miraculously provided for them and listened to Jesus' teaching, all of a sudden, the crowds turned against Jesus. And they rejected him and they yelled out, "Crucify him. Crucify him." Well, who else could have helped Jesus in this time of need? The disciples. Jesus had 12 disciples who followed him everywhere, who saw all of the miracles that he worked, who heard all of the teachings that he taught. They never saw Jesus do anything wrong. And you would think that after all these people are betraying Jesus, you would think that the disciples would rise up and do something in Jesus' hour of need and help Jesus. Did the disciples do that? When Jesus was arrested, all the disciples fled. In fact, Judas Iscariot, who was one of the 12 disciples, he's the one who sold Jesus for 30 pieces of silver to the religious leaders. So one of his own disciples betrayed him. And then Peter, when three different people asked him, "Do you know Jesus?" They said, "Surely you know Jesus. You were with him before." And Peter kept saying, "No, I don't even know the man." So Peter denied Jesus. So his own disciples betrayed him. One sold him for 30 pieces of silver, the other one denied him, the rest ran away. Only John was there when Jesus was crucified, and all John could do was just stand there and watch. John didn't really do anything. Well, how about Jesus' family? You would think that his brothers and sisters, the Bible says Jesus had brothers and sisters, you would think that they would try to do something to help him. I mean, after all of these people are betraying him, they see an innocent man being punished, you would think that they would be the ones to try to help him. But the Bible says that there was a time when Jesus was teaching, and his brothers and sisters actually came to try to take him away by force because they said he's crazy. They said Jesus is crazy. They said he thinks he's a Messiah. He must be crazy. So even his brothers and sisters rejected him. Well, there's one who has more power and more authority and more ability than all these people who could have saved Jesus. That's Jesus' own Father, Father in heaven. In fact, Jesus prayed to the Father before his time of need. And he said, because he knew it was coming. He knew his big problem was coming. And he said, "Father, if you can save me from this time, please do it. But not what I want, what you want. I want what you want, Father." So Jesus, he really wanted, if there was a way, to be saved from his time of need. So did the Father save Jesus? Even his Father rejected him. That's pretty heavy, that God rejected Jesus. The reason why is because there was a time when Jesus was hanging on the cross. The sins of the world were put on him. Remember, we've been learning about sacrifice in the Old Testament? Jesus was our sacrifice. The wrong things that you've done, the wrong things that I've done, the wrong things that the whole world has done were put on Jesus. And Jesus felt the weight of that. And to make it even worse, his Father, being perfect, now we don't understand God's holiness, but God is so holy that he cannot look upon sin. He can't be in sin's presence. So his Father had to turn his back on his Son. And for the first time ever, Jesus and the Father were separated. See, you know, I've got a father, and I've known my father for 51 years, but Jesus has known his Father forever and ever and ever, and they've always been together. And their love for each other is perfect love. And yet, at that moment, in Jesus' greatest time of need, the Father had to turn his back on Jesus. The Bible says Jesus became sin let me quote it right. The Bible says, "He who knew no sin became sin for us, so that we could become righteous, so that we could be clean." And so, in Jesus' greatest time of need, the Father had to turn his back on Jesus. But the good news is, 3 days later, Jesus rose from the dead, and he conquered death and hell and the grave. And he was restored to fellowship with his Father, and he can bring us to fellowship with God too. Because like I said, our sins were put on Jesus, and he was rejected so that we could be accepted. That's what this whole season is all about, is Jesus' sacrifice. He paid the price that we deserve to pay. Because when you guys have done wrong, and when I've done wrong, we deserve to be punished for our wrong things. But Jesus took the punishment for us. I think that's pretty amazing. I would like to lead you guys in a prayer right now. So if you guys would please bow your heads, and if you could pray silently with me, I'm going to pray, and I'll just say a few words, and I'll pause, and I'll let you repeat it silently, and we'll pray together. Heavenly Father, I know I'm a sinner. I know I've done wrong things, but I know Jesus died for me. I know he shed his blood for me. I know that I could become a new person because of what Jesus did. Thank you for the precious blood of Jesus. Thank you for bringing me into a fellowship with you, bringing me into your family. Thank you that Jesus was rejected so that I could be accepted. In Jesus' name. Amen. God's blood, take it away.
All right, guys, go ahead and stand on up for our video talk.
You are commanded.
My joy is mine.